obviously, being down here in South Florida, it's very hot, so that's pretty tough for kids. Carrying an instrument and playing and marching at the same time, that takes a lot of energy, a lot of physicality. So they got to be in shape, they got to be able to, you know, push through when it's really hot out or they're getting tired.
You're basically constantly moving and you're putting a lot of oxygen towards the muscles that are pushing the air out of your body quick and sometimes very forcefully. And that is also, if you don't watch it, could be a little hard to handle.
I think there's always like this breaking point. You're just like over it, you're just, I don't want to do this anymore, it's hot. Or maybe you're even in sentence, like, I'm just tired, I've been doing this for 8 hours, 7 hours, how many hours, you know? It's about determination, you know? You need to be determined to keep going, you know? It's just raising the bar each time. And that still happens throughout every practice.
A couple difficult things are, it's really when things slow down, people, they get off focus, and there's not much you can really do other than retrain yourself to get back in the zone.
The same 8 counts, the same 4 sets, the same 2 sets even, every practice until we can finally do run-throughs of movements or the entire show.
A lot of dehydration, but you know, we managed to push through it. There's a lot of like stress going on because we really do want to strive to be better.
I guess whenever we had to like pull up our horns a lot, even though I'm a trumpet and people can kind of complain about that, it still hurts for the first time in like a very long time. And I guess times like that, and also when I'm sore after like when we have little breaks after lunch, also like super like sweaty and gross sometimes. It gets a bit exhausting sometimes.
Oh, well, we live in Florida, so that heat is very, very exhausting. There was one rehearsal, it was 1 to 6 we were rehearsing, and people were dropping so quick because of the heat. And we had to take, I think, an extended water break because people were just left and right leaving the field because they were feeling nauseous or passing out, and the heat really gets to you.
The weather is definitely a difficulty, you know. There's a lot of people that are not used to spending more than like 10 minutes, you know, in the heat at a time. So definitely, especially the long marching camps of 8 hours, 10 hours, you know, the sun is definitely a factor. You know, especially when I was marching my freshman and sophomore year, it's definitely very rewarding. You know, you spend 10 hours outside just learning new things, drilling the same things, and you know, once you get home after those long days, it's very rewarding to, you know, achieve so much.
It was cool seeing like all the freshmen like getting in like on the visual stuff and playing. They're like, oh, I don't really know what to do. It's like really cool watching people learn and experience things for the first time and seeing how they take it.
Well, after several years, these people that you've sweated so much with, they just become family. And you know, you grow very close to the people that you're doing this with because it's, you spend hundreds of hours working on this show, and like after rehearsals and during breaks, you're just like, you get to talk to each other and you get closer that way.
We run a lot. At the end of the day, we always laugh, we make side jokes, inside jokes, and we're just with each other for the 3 hours in the excruciating heat.
Marching band has honestly made me so happy. To me, marching band is like one huge family who like shares this passion for music and for marching, and we work so hard together and we share this emotional connection.
There's this big, big family, welcoming family. just waiting for you. That's very accepting.
Once you start getting into that rhythm and get the physical strength for it, it becomes a lot, not easier, but it's better to do, you know?
I think it's the one activity out of the program where everybody gets to be together. Obviously, there's a lot more involved physically. And yes, it's after school, but it seems that that's the one thing the kids have the most fun with overall throughout the whole program. So that's what I would say.
Marching band is just a really good activity to get people involved in, a different form of music instead of sitting down and playing like your classical Bach or your whole suite. It's a really good way for members of the band to get to know each other. It's just a really fun activity.
When you're spending hours upon hours with these people, even if they are strangers like they were at the beginning, a lot of them, you're spending quality time face-to-face with these people. That makes them, most of them, become your friends.
It's really a cool place to be. You can make a lot of friends in band. You can really talk to people and stuff.
I like the people. Maybe it's because of my two really weird friends that make it really fun. No matter how hard it is, like, they always make me laugh.
Most of the band because I enjoy playing the instrument. I also have lots of friends in band, like most of the people I talk to are in band. And it's kind of just overall just a fun experience for me.
It helps me form relationships with people that I would never normally have in school. You get really close friends that are probably going to be with me for life, and it's really nice to have those relationships.
I like how, you know, close everybody is. At the beginning of the year, you know, it seems that, you know, not a whole lot of people know each other. I mean, there's the upperclassmen and there's the different groups of people who are kind of friends to begin with. But then when the freshmen come in, it's very interesting to see how everybody kind of falls into these different friend groups.
When you join marching band, at first you don't know anybody. After the season, you realize when you're walking around school, there's so many kids that you know and they know you. You kind of know each other by name. It makes it really good to start off as a freshman.
Band basically brought me and my group of friends together. I mean, I wouldn't have known them if I didn't join band.
It's
all the people I get to see every day. When you come into the big blue box, it's really special because it's basically, you know, home away from home. And the people inside are extended family now.
Something that's definitely special is that, you know, you might not be the best player, you might not be the best marcher, but just to be able to work as a group and just function as one ginormous unit of people, I think that's a very special aspect because there's not many other clubs or things you do where, you know, you have to be relied on by such a big group of people. Because if you're, you know, if there's a hole in the marching show, if there's a part that's not heard, I mean, that's on you, you know? And it's definitely important, you know? And it's very special, you know? There's nothing else like it.
Life lessons. There are a few in there, like if it's like, especially if you're having like a tough rehearsal day or like something's not going your way, it's sort of like rough, like in between, and there are ups and downs to like a journey, but like it's, I think that the journey is more important than where you end up. The skills that you learn, everything involved with that, the relationships that you make with the people around you, I think that the journey is a super important part, like not to miss. Like, don't just wait for that end goal. Oh, I can't wait to see what it's finally gonna look like. Just enjoy learning parts of it and just taking your time.
Just wanna get on with the show, and we're just standing there with each other, waiting to move on, and that's when you actually make the friendships on the water break. Then we start playing, you understand each other's struggle. Once we get work put in, once we see their illusions put in, and we just work together to try to make it the best show possible, and I really love that, the atmosphere.
Learning drill is definitely not an easy task, especially with so many people on the field and so like a little like staff to help us out. Like not everyone has their own personal marching tech. It's a lot of self-corrections. Like, I get to the yard line too early. What do I gotta do to fix it? Do I need a bigger step one? Am I taking even size step count all the way through?
Memorization was definitely a big problem for me, especially the first 2 years, I think. And I've learned to just kind of take it slow. You take the music and like go measure by measure, just kind of finger through it 100 times, 1,000 times.
Yeah, over time, definitely a lot of improvements. I've seen people in pit who went from not knowing anything in music to like being the best that they can.
We endure a lot of exhaustion and pain and injuries, but we still always push through to make it the best show possible.
Responsibilities and know what's going on, what am I doing? And then sometimes little things that like you don't know what you're doing wrong, that's why we have the text there and they'll help everyone out. They're like, okay, here, it's this line that's not moving in conjunction, they can see bigger picture stuff.
Well, I was in the pit. So pit, you were always working on your music. If you weren't working on your music, it was because either you're on a small break or you didn't have it.
Well, typical pit rehearsal, you basically spend 20 minutes setting up the biggest things and the biggest instruments in the band room. You yell at people to get out. Now we warm up. We chunk through a couple sections. We try to push ourselves to go faster and like be more accurate and not miss any notes.
Otherwise, it was, you're working on your music, you're playing the music over and over.
Yeah, you basically repeat the same thing over and over again, so you'd be more accurate.
And the pit, we had ours pretty down because we didn't have to learn all the drill. But the one thing we did have to learn is how to push out quickly because you're timed when you go to the competition.
Just a lot of love, support. We feel each other's pain, we feel each other's struggle, and we try to understand each other and build the relationships further to enjoy our time.
And then we just start stretching. Izzy and Clement will usually meet us there or try to beat us, and then we'll start to the point where we have this whole thing of, okay, weapons over here, flags over here, and then dancers over here. We're kind of just in our own section, and then from that point we're able to come together and just mix it and blend.
We take chunks, like we start off in the beginning of the show, we would take it over and over and over again, and it's very repetitive, but honestly, we get the job done. At the end of the day, we've perfected that, and we can move on to the next thing.
I like marching because you don't just meet, it's not just guard, you don't just stay with guard, you meet the instruments, percussion, pit, and you just make friendships with everybody and you all understand each other's struggle. Although guard is different than playing an instrument, we tend to say that, oh, I can never do what they do, and then they say they can never do what we do, and it's just like a cute little family.
Band camp. Whew, okay. If you've never done it before, you have no idea what it is. You're probably excited the night before. If you're an upperclassman, you're not excited the night before. Six rehearsals. They're 10 hours long. They're probably going to be in the sun for the majority of the time. You'll learn the majority of the marching show. You'll learn basics-wise, you'll learn everything. Music-wise, we'll drill everything hundreds and hundreds of times. It's definitely, it gives you a taste of what the marching season's like, and it's probably the worst it'll get.
Band camp is nothing like actual band camp, because pre-band camp is like smaller and it's just getting basic skills, while band camp is just, it kind of just like starts the entire season basically.
It's really worth it. You know, you get out of bed at like 6:30, 7 in the morning and you're just like, wow, I really don't want to do this. And then, you know, your parents push you out the door anyways. They're like, you got to do this. And, you know, you get there and you get into it and you're just like, wow, I'm really glad I did this. And it's a lot of work, but it's also the bulk of, you know, spending time with each other, getting the show together. And that's really cool.
Basics, and then we move on to horn arc, warm up, get playing. So memorizing the music is definitely fun. Watching everyone, it's like, ah, it's A flat, blah blah blah, and then we work through it. That's cool. And then we start learning drill. After we do some drill, do a little review, go back for lunch, and then we sort of just do the process a little bit again. It's like two halves of marching band.
Practice for the marching band is we usually rehearse Mondays 6 to 9, Thursdays 3 to 6, sometimes on Fridays. Again, that's sometimes some of the hottest part of the day. We're on a blacktop for some of those rehearsals and sometimes on the field. Well, obviously, the more practice you can get in, hopefully the better the performances will be, as long as they're productive. You know, we try not to overdo it. We try and rehearse the best we can with the time we have.
So on Thursdays we have rehearsal where right after school gets out at 2:40 and at 3 o'clock we have to be out on the field, so that literally only gives us time to change and go right out there.
Yeah, so after a long day at school, you know, 4 or 5 classes, you know, your brain is fried, then immediately, boom, marching band mode. We start off by stretching, you know, it starts out relaxed, which is nice, because it gives you a break from, you know, school. We all know how stressful that is, especially during AP.
Sometimes if you're having like a bad day, like a test like bummed you out, it's a little stressful out there, but I think that being on the marching field is somewhere where you don't have to worry about all the other stuff that just happened at school or what's coming about later. You just have to focus on working with the members of your section, members of your the group, the members of the band, the color guard, the pit, everyone working together towards one product. You can sort of put those things out of your mind and just be like, all right, I'm here to the band, this is going to be fun, I love this show, I like this mellow part I have here. So I think it can be really relaxing when you're out there and you're just having fun, having time, but you're also really working hard.
And then we look at the next one, we can like mark the one that we were on and then go to that one, and we fix that form, mark that, and you go back and you run that once, twice, until you kind of get the hang of it, and then you do it a few more times to like get the muscle memory for it, and then you move on to the next set, and then you'll do that set a couple times, and then you'll do both sets, and then you'll eventually just keep going that over and over again, and you learn the show.
Yeah, I was really nervous at first, but then I realized that you just gotta play and then let go. It's fun.
We're going right into it. It's like no slacking, especially during music time. It's just like 1, 2, 3, go. We're not like stopping or anything during that whole session. It's like we're gonna keep practicing until you guys get it, and it's like on time thing, and they keep going.
You know, there's maybe, you know, our drum major or our band captain might give a speech or two to motivate us, Dan. You know, that's all to prepare us for what the next 2 hours is going to happen. What's going to happen is we're going to rehearse with all our hearts.
Well, for 3 to 6 rehearsals that we have on Thursdays and Fridays, it starts off with, you know, the school bell rings, you change in your clothes super quick, go out for a run, stretch, chug as much water as you can. and then we'll usually go into basics, or we'll go straight into drill. By the time the school year starts, we have the majority of our drill already learned. So we're cleaning, adding in visuals, you know, kind of fine-tuning some things at this point.
We show up, we do a quick warm-up outside on the fields, right? And then we get right into it. We might do a little bit of PT before, then we get straight to our view a couple sets, and we'll get right into new sets, and it's kind of fun.
It was so much, because it was band camp. We had like 10 to like 9 hours of practice doing all this work, but after school rehearsal was only like 3 to 4 hours, so they were like, the instructors and the band director were like, we have to keep going, we have to get this done.
Once the staff feels that it's ready, they decide, okay, we're gonna try to put music to this and to warm us up, and then we'll go and play like the couple sets at a time and do that a couple times until they think it's decent, and then we'll just keep going on and on and on until you got the music to the drill and it's good.
Thinking is, what can I do better? It's not about me in particular, but it's about the whole group. What can we do to get better?
It's really cool, especially when we do like block stuff and we see it, have everyone moving together and have everyone on the same page. That's really dope.
We all get there, we get into half uniform, go to the blacktop, do our thing for, I don't know, half an hour or less, usually. And then we come back, put on full uniform, line up in score order. Well, everybody does a ritual. Most of the sections have their own little ritual we do pregame. I would tell you what we do, but it's a secret.
Those are really inside jokes, maybe. You know, someone did something stupid the other week or something, you just want to bring attention to that. But it's another way the family bonds together, and it's a ton of fun. Inspection is, it's really a moment of focus, to get all your thoughts together, what you need, what you have mentally, not just physically, as in, do you have your horn, do you have your mouthpiece, do you have your shako. It's really about getting everything else together, remembering all the visuals you need, all your sets, all your dots. It's really a moment of reflection on everything you need and everything you have done already. It's really intense.
Oh, well, football games, other than our halftime performance, are usually more laid back. We play what we call stands tunes, and those are fun little tunes that we play to cheer on the football team or mess up the opposing team. A lot of the stances that we do, we have little choreographed dancing that we do in the stands.
You know, it's all about having a good time, and nobody's really too strict, and you get to, you know, really get to know everybody in your section that you might not have the opportunity to do at rehearsals. And it's, you know, it might be really hot, it might be really rainy, but everybody's together and, you know, so close together that, you know, you really get to bond and get to know everyone.
A couple of our stand tunes start off with a tuba solo, which is really fun. And then everybody comes in.
We have a couple of pretty dope stand tunes. We do Kool-Aid and ESPN. Both of those start with me, like the tuba player, just like going for it. And then the rest of the band joins in. And those are just really fun, just like everyone's playing them. We're like, and then there's the chant for Kool-Aid. And the football games are really fun. Is the some more social part of a band, just hanging out with your guys, watching football, cheering on the team. It's a lot of fun.
Football games, you have a lot of fun. You have fun with your friends, you're sitting with your section. You guys laugh and play music for the football team, cheer them on. You cheer on your fans as well. And during halftime, you know, we perform our show, and you know, everyone leaves their heart out on the field no matter what, no matter where you're performing, whether it's at a competition or a football game, because you know, you still have your family out there watching you, and you always want to make someone proud.
Seeing what we've worked so hard for, and at least for me, and I know that's the same for most of the people at Stand Marching Band, it gives you a rush that you can't get anywhere else, and that's why I do marching band.
First time you walk on the field, it's just like all eyes on you, you're just like, oh my gosh, it's just like after you like leap that field, it's like such an amazing feeling to like I finally did this after all this work, I did it.
Football games are totally different from competitions because there's a totally different feel. I mean, yes, there's still people. Sometimes there's another band.
Obviously, if we have a competition coming up, then the focus on those rehearsals is going to be for whatever that performance is, whether it could be marching, could be jazz, could be a concert, you know, that we have coming up. We're going to make sure that those are the things that we're trying to pinpoint to get ready for that event.
Takes a lot of effort, but in the end you'll see, you know, you'll reap what you sow. You know, there's that breaking point when you push past, that's a new limit. You just set your standard even higher than what it was before. That still happens throughout every practice, maybe 2-3 weeks before states. They're asking you, I need more sound, and you're just like, I don't have any more sound to give me, you know? And somewhere, you know, you find how to play louder, how to march better, keep that technique, but still play the exact same way that you were before. You know, it's teaches you a lot of things, and it's definitely raising the bar each time. Mm-hmm.
Well, a marching competition day is a long day. It you know, involves moving a lot of people, equipment. You got to get there early so that you can go into warm up and do your stretching and all that. And then, depending on where you are in the lineup, obviously, of the bands, you may go on relatively early or you may have to go on late. You're going to have to stay until the award ceremony is done and pack it all back up, head back home. So it can be a 10 to 12 hour day, you know, with everything that's involved.
Competition's a bit different. We really do have to show, like, we represent our school, so we have to show, like, how serious we can be and how dedicated. Once you go through a couple competitions, you'll start like not being as nervous anymore. But I'm always a little bit nervous because I always like, I'm scared I'm gonna mess up just the slightest, and I always do attempt to like do the best I possibly can because I do care about this program a lot.
As long as it feels like it was a great time and you know that it was a good show and you did your best, it was amazing. Morning of States is it's a very early morning, but it's also a very exciting one because we know what's going to happen is that we're going to be able to perform at the state level, you know, and that's something not a lot of people get to say.
It's definitely very emotional for some people, and the retreat is huge. You know, it's not easy to hear, you know, the bands being announced on the loudspeaker, but, you know, everybody's super focused. Everybody's super, you know, nervous about the results. There's definitely a lot of hurry up and wait, and I think it's like that with every other competition we have, but it's at a much larger scale with FMBC because we're, you know, there, we're completely submerged.
It's amazing, honestly, like you're just thinking about, you know, this is months of work culminating into one point, and you're just trying to remember all the things that you typically do, you know, oh, make sure you tongue stop here, or staccato, legato, don't play too loud here, softer, louder, you know, dynamics and whatnot.
A lot of the people were scared, for freshmen, obviously, because It was a new experience, new environment to march in, so they didn't know what to expect. And we, a lot of the upperclassmen, we tried to help them out and kind of get their nerves a little bit down. But once we were in there, it was like, for the entire ensemble, it was a new feeling of like seriousness, I guess you could say, and focus on what we were about to do.
So although it should have been there the whole season, it was there stronger than ever at the Dome.
Just like seeing it like outside, you're just like, whoa, what is that? It's huge. Just marching there is like, there's a lot of echo. Just like hearing that tap, it's just like echo, echo, back and forth. It's just like, oh my gosh. So it was like really important to watch the drum major, both drum majors, and like watch what they're doing and not like listen out for the band.
Walking through the Dome, see, I've been there before my freshman year, so I knew what it sounded like, but it was surreal to be back again. And hearing the echo, it was insane, because for this show, they were like, being in the Dome, you need to know your count. And for our show, most of our work doesn't really go with count, so we learn it by music, and the echo literally freaked a lot of us out. People even started crying before we went on, but we still pushed through to the end.
It's definitely a lot more nerve-wracking than the other competition would be. And, you know, after the warm-up, we perform, we take our pictures, you know, everybody's crying, everybody, you know, is super emotional because they might have just performed their last show.
States, it was pretty nice. I had fun, and I just, like, it was my last year because I'm a senior. And, you know, I cried because it's like, you know, this is my last time performing on this field. Leave it all on the field, and yeah.
I do recall like the moment when we had finished. I remember like, I don't know, I guess it's like the entire like season had flashed in my eyes, and I just remember like every single practice and everything that happened.
I was still happy because, you know, we finished it and we did as good as we could have possibly done. That's what I believe. I remember during our performance at the end, I made eye contact with one of the members on the field, and we just basically locked eyes and smiled like idiots back and forth at each other for the rest of the performance. It was great.
Once you finish, knowing that you've had a really good run, it's just the greatest. It's a bittersweet moment once you finish. You're happy and sad at the same time, knowing it's your last season since I'm a senior and stuff. But It's just really nice. I don't have any words for it. You just have to be there and you have to experience for yourself what's going on.
You know, afterwards there was like some emotion, not just because of the placement that we got, but because, you know, seniors, it's their last time doing this. And, you know, we got two times in the Dome, which was cool. But it's always sad when things come to an end, especially something like so involving and special such as this.
Today, I think everyone had a bunch of lessons to take away from marching band. Not necessarily like marching band related, but like sort of like a couple of life lessons, like how to manage time, how to work with others for like a project. Seeing like some of my section leaders, some of my friends, like work with the freshmen and the sophomores on music.
Never once was I singled out because I was in 9th, 10th, or 11th grade. You know, it's a big family, and that's what I appreciate most about it. And that's what I think draws a lot of people to it, because when you come into high school, you don't know anyone, and then, you know, there's this big, big family, welcoming family, just waiting for you. That's very accepting. I also think that marching band teaches you determination to keep going even though it's hard. You know, the freshmen coming in are very, very well equipped, very talented. It's a very talented freshman class, you know, and I think there are leaders definitely that are going to rise up in the next coming years.
So, Angelica, sorry to disturb you in your peaceful afternoon. How has life been so far?
It's been good. Very good.
What have you been up to so far? How many kids do you have?
How many kids? You know, everyone is my child.
Aww. So is there any final words you'd like to say to the rest of us?
Namaste, Namyo, Rengekyo.
Aww.
Peace, love, and pixie dust.
How could this have happened?
Subject seems to be dead. 17.
What? What do you want in my life? What?
Can't go now.
No, we can't go. I'm not that shady.
So Zen, how do you feel today about to get a brand new makeover by the famous Hollywood MUA, Gabriella Jimena Cruz?
I'm elated.
These are my awards. We're gonna fix you up great. I'm also a nurse, so if you feel faint, I got you. Okay. Just doing your eyebrows with Anastasia. Gonna get you some Kylie Jenner lips. Big is never enough. Gonna fluff you up. Perfect.
Hi, I'm Dang Mimsha from UNC Chapel Hill Journalism Squad, and today I'm interviewing Chance the Rapper.
Hey, this ain't no intro, this the entree. Hit that intro.
So my first question is, how has your life changed since you became a successful rap artist?
Teaching taxes in school. It don't even matter, I was acting a fool. But who would think the raps would turn in?
And finally, what's your take on memes?
Everybody outside, when I pull up outside all night though. Everybody high.
Thank you for giving me your time today. And this has been Dank Meme Shit yeeting off.
Good morning, sky. Good morning, trees. Good morning, grass. Oh, didn't see you there. I'm Lauren Goldstein, but you can call me vegan. Today, I'll show you all about the day in the life of me, Lauren Goldstein, a vegan.
Just give me a minute while I finish my morning routine.
Today I'll be making a nice vegan breakfast for my two children, Nelson and Nelson. Aren't they cute?
Yeah.
And this is the final product, a vegan's favorite meal, water. My kids just love it.
My client has done nothing wrong.
You stole fizzy lifting drinks.
No, Mr. Wonka, we're chill.
You have no evidence that my client, Charlie Bucket, has stolen fizzy lifting drinks.
Wow, you're such a good lawyer. You're right, I have no evidence.
Ka-chow! Of course I'm right. Now off to my next case of the missing pink ping pong ball.
Deliver this pizza.
Finally finished the Blue Coats 2028 show music. Let's see how it sounds.
it's totally original.
Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed. She was looking kind of dumb with her finger and her thumb and the shape of an L on her forehead. Well, the years start coming and they don't stop coming. Fed to the rules and I hit the ground running. Didn't make sense not to live for fun. Your brain gets smart but your head gets dumb. So much to do, so much to see, so what's wrong? You'll never know if you don't go. You'll never shine if you don't glow. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid.
And all that glitters is gold.
Only shooting stars break the mold.
Hey Brennan, let's go jump on that train.
Okay. Jackson, I'm stuck. Help.
Gasp! I gotta help!
Choo choo, I am a train. I am going to run you over. Choo.
Stop! Brennan, let me help you. Let me get you out of here.
Thanks for saving me, Jackson.
I gotta use my super strength for something. Now let's look at the sunset.
And now, awarding the rank of 11-star general for saving this puppy, Sarah Townsend.
Thank you for your service to our country.
Ring, ring.
911, what's your emergency?
I've fallen and I can't get up.
Alright. Duty calls.
My arm!
Coming to see you.
It's all good.
Hey, you got the stuff?
Yeah, I do.
Okay.
Got the money?
Yep.
Stop, DEA!
Nothing. Totally not some agricultural supplies.
It looks
something.
I don't illegal. Have anything, sir. That's illegal seizure. You're not allowed to do that.
What
you
is
don't
this?
Have a. That's sugar.
Sugar.
And this?
Kale, organically grown at my farm.
Well, let's see.
Is it kale?
It's kale.
It's kale.
You'll get him next time, Brad.
All right. We are here today to pronounce Chris Evans and Kelsey Bailey to be husband and wife. All right. So do you, Chris Evans, or otherwise known as Captain America, take Kelsey Bailey to be your lawfully wedded wife?
I do.
Do you, Kelsey Bailey, take Chris Evans to be your lawfully wedded husband.
I do.
You may now kiss the bride. All right, I'm done here. I've been better, but you know, ever since I've aged out of the Boston Crusaders, my life has felt so empty.
Why have you felt empty? Tell me more about it.
Because I can't do my favorite thing, which is march DCI.
Okay, well, I think I may have a solution for you that's very good.
What is it?
It's called memes, dank memes. And I have a bunch of them for you right here. I mean, just look at these. Like that baby meme right there?
Yes.
I mean, if you want the memes, just all the memes.
Yes! Perfect, it's so good!
See, now you can use memes to fulfill your life, since you don't have DCI to fulfill your life anymore.
New pastime, how would you like your pancakes scrambled? So good, I love them.
I'm glad we fixed your problems. Yes. Now that will be $8,000, please.
What?
You know, the fee.
I don't have that money.
We'll get that money.
Can't! I don't want your memes!
Is that so much to ask? Harami. Harami.
Hello, my name is Nicholas Antonio Vargas Perez Saavedra, and I'm going to be trying out for the UF Honor Band. And I will be playing Donnelly. Hi, my name is Nicholas, University of Florida Saavedra, and I'm going to be playing Donnelly, which I auditioned for. Just wanted to show you guys how much I got better.
Boy!
Hey, Andrea, listen to this.
Boy!
Why hear something to me?
I'm sorry if that question that asked last scared you, but like a hazmat and gasmat if I rap. Wait, what's the word again? Boy!
Now that I got these amazing shots, I can go edit them at Church by the Glade. Let's go!
Yeah.
I'm out!
Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh! Is that Nick Hatch, the striker for Manchester United? Oh my goodness! Oh my!
So, Amber, how's life after high school?
You know, I just graduated from UF. No big deal. Top 10% valedictorian. What? I'm a neonatal nurse. That's so good for me.
That's an alpha.
Alpha?
Yeah!
Like both?
Yeah, a little bit.
No, not good. Yes, girl, yes, right.
To go forward through the mirror of introspection. This mirror reveals a reflection of your true emotions.
What do people really think about me? Does anybody actually like me? Will I ever amount to anything?
The answers to these questions will lead you back to the real world. You must open the door to your heart and remove your negative feelings. They only hide the truth of who you really are. Self-image to be set free.
Is your band ready? Ladies and gentlemen, the Coral Springs High School Marching Colts.
This year is a gateway to a new world. What beware.
control your destiny, or you will be brought in through the mirror.
Thank you.
Remember, you could be everything you want to be. What do you want to be?
It's okay if I don't fit in. It really doesn't matter what people think about me. I'm like me. I control my destiny. The marriage doesn't define me. I must win this battle.
Springs High School Marching Colts!